17 days without let-up, American planes and ships assault the island of Guam in the Marianas. 5,000 miles from San Francisco, 1,500 miles from Tokyo and Manila. Now, a shattering zero-hour bombardment by the combined forces. For attack, most of the Navy's 5th Fleet and ships of the United States 3rd Amphibious Group. A mighty striking force, superbly equipped in manpower and materiel, and in the accumulated experience of a dozen previous major invasions since the Great Pacific Offensive began. Landing barges and amphibious tractors streamed toward shore, bearing first wave Marine landing troops. Exactly 31 months and 9 days from the date of Japanese conquest, the return to Guam. PC boats accompany the assault wave, their guns pounding the shore. Now, enemy fire is heavy. 3 landing craft are hit. In growing strength, troops and equipment strike for the beach. In 3.5 hours of fierce fighting, Marines gain a toehold on Guam's western shore. Flag on the beachhead. A wounded Marine fights on. Light artillery comes up to support the advance elements, fighting inland ahead of schedule with flamethrower, rifle, grenade, and machine gun. Installations wrecked by the fury of the combined offensive. The price of success is not small. with the control of Guam, American forces have now acquired an invaluable base only 5 bomber hours from the Philippines and Japan. Generals Geiger, Turnage, and Noble inspect frontline positions on Guam. The retaking of strategic territory in the Pacific continues.